Hey, I'm Jonathan Wild, and we cover how to use first in, first out for inventory costing under a perpetual inventory system. The first in, first out, or FIFO inventory method assumes that the earliest inventory items purchased are the first to be sold. For example, let's say a company bought three identical units of inventory. One unit on June 2nd for $10, one unit on the 4th for $11, and one unit on the 25th for $15. On June 28th, we sold one unit for $21. Using FIFO, the first unit purchased, which was on June 2nd for $10, is reported as cost of goods sold on the income statement. The other two remaining units for $11 and $15 get reported in inventory on the balance sheet. As you can see, under FIFO, the earliest unit purchased is sent to cost of goods sold on the income statement first. The FIFO method can only be used when our inventory consists of identical units. For example, if we are selling identical gallons of milk, we could use the FIFO method. However, if we are selling one-of-a-kind custom artwork, we would not use FIFO. Okay, let's do an example. Assume our records show that on May 1st, we had 20 units in beginning inventory that had cost $30 each. We fill that information into our table under beginning balance. On May 3rd, we purchased 30 units at $35 per unit. Now looking at our inventory balance, we see 20 units at $30 each from beginning inventory and 30 units at $35 each. On May 5th, we sold 35 units. Using first in, first out, or FIFO, we put the first 20 units sold at the earliest cost of $30 each, and the next 15 sold at a cost of $35 each in the cost of goods sold column. This leaves us with 15 units in inventory at $35 each. On May 11th, we purchased 5 units at $45 per unit. Now, looking at our inventory balance, we see 15 units at $35 each and 5 units at $45 each. On May 28th, we purchased 10 units at $48 per unit. Looking at our inventory balance, we see 15 units at $35, 5 units at $45, and 10 units at $48. On May 31st, we sold 25 units. Using first in, first out, or FIFO, we put the 25 units purchased first in cost of goods sold. So that includes 15 units at $35, 5 units at $45, and 5 units at $48. Looking at inventory, that leaves us with 5 units at $48 each. Last, we total our cost of goods sold to $2,115, which is reported on the income statement. We also see we have $240 left in inventory at the end of the month, and we report this on the balance sheet.